stream will be very, very sleepy. It's still really early in the morning, though awfully bright. I got a bunch of for fuzzy socks. But I gotta admit, these are pretty awesome insofar as fuzzy socks are concerned. Michael loves fuzzy socks, so he'll definitely get some use. I'll probably be shaving before my stream. Yeah, Michael gave like an insane amount of them as Christmas gifts this year. In case they're breathable. So let's see what else. I mean, they really go all out. Some sort of not current. I wonder why this never auto-focuses. Like if that's a setting I need to do. No, definitely not. And I don't think it's personalized or anything. I think she wrote on it herself. She must just be good. Stuff, but the eye stuff makes sense to me. Should I just put them on? Let's see, there's no directions whatsoever. This is made of snail, too. Is that what I'm supposed to do? Or get it closer to the eye? We'll try it. Skin. But yeah, I'll be shaving today. This out of control beard. As you can see, I do this very often, as you can tell. It's sticking now. Okay, I shouldn't touch it. Okay, where were we? Oh. Ladies sure do like their chapstick. I'll give this to Michael. Let's see what else we got in here. Now this is what I always look for in my gift bags. Gift cards. They always, like, as part of trying to get morale up, they keep giving us these, like, themed masks, which is useful. And this one comes with a McDonald's gift card. This one comes with another fast food place gift card, a mask, and some hot cocoa. I hadn't worked at the library since, like, probably October, maybe November. So, a lot of this you'll notice is Christmas gifts or Christmas themed. still wear them regularly, but they started giving those out at like the heart of COVID when the library was still open and morale was pretty low. So this looks like a little flu season gift bag. Centers for the homeless. Oh no. I'm not very good at masks, apparently. So, not sure if this connects with the flu season theme, but we also got a Hershey's chocolate bar. As much of a hodgepodge as that bag was, that's probably the most useful one for me with the tissues and the sanitizer. I work with too many unclean folk, so. coworkers who I've met before, they came in and it's library month, and there's an activity to write what you love about the library, and the little girl wrote the librarian, so that always feels nice. I don't know why I had this. I don't know if I missed Mardi Gras. It's not even happened yet, but and it's funny you say personal development. I wish it was and said it's professional development, but yeah, exactly. I was trying to cram in 10 hours of professional development while working a super busy shift. The sanitizer after this, then. I think I just had these in here from like 10 years ago or something. Licensure paperwork and also the fake job of doing professional development. It's almost always people who haven't been in a classroom in like 20 years and telling us how to make sure we talk calmly, and then magically your kids won't cuss you out. Industries and capitalism, it's really just a self-serving loop. Loop, 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 loop. If we got rid of that bureaucracy, then people would lose jobs, and that would be bad. Thanks for the follow, Noir Navra. So in similar work, but like an apprenticeship, going deeper. a certain type, or is this not what you already do? Between you, me, and Jonathan, we could finally make the video game I want to make. Oh, okay. Yeah, all the coding my mom did was for, like, machining companies and stuff. Fussy socks. Sunny. It's always sunny in Philadelphia. Gamblers. They go into, Frank and Charlie go into the sewers to look for, like, coins and treasures, as they call it, in the sewers. Funny, like, dungeon crawler platformer. I have a whole bunch of ideas for it. My big challenge is the graphics. I'm not an art drawer. Jonathan said he's pretty good with pixel art, and I've made a lot of type games which he developed, but sounds like you'd have a more expertise in the intricacies of the code, even if I can get the platforming down. So let's see what's inside here. So fussy, I guess, but definitely Christmas themed. And Michael likes long socks, so I'm making a pile for Michael things, including his anal beads you mentioned. And then of the things I'll actually use, and then the things I won't. Done with this. Well, speaking of something for Michael, this is actually a cool little idea. It's a keychain that can hold your chapstick, which Michael's always losing his chapstick. On stream for like unintentional typing ASMR, but I'll do that next week since we already almost did 30 minutes of this. So that goes in the Michael pile. I don't think either of us really eats treats. I kind of enjoy it. I sort of enjoy doing taxes. Just because I like typing things in. Oh wow, they're automated. That must be nice. There's also a random candy cane. I don't really fuck with candy canes, but when I did used to try them, this was like the flavor, you know, that I liked, the multicolor ones. Oh, so that's a similar amount as here, and it's definitely not over that much. There's just two pieces of candy in this one. Kinda random. This is I don't know if you've ever worked at a business with predominantly women working there, but at least here in the United States, every potential holiday or reason to give gifts, you get a bunch of candy and random things you might or might not use. Now, again, I missed Christmas, so I think that's pretty normal to give some gifts around the office, so to speak. Just all my coworkers at the library. When I showed up at the library, I'll have to post the photo. There was just like, my mailbox was just crammed full of socks and plastic bags. And I mean, this was the most obvious, and I was just shoved in there. So yeah. And when I saw that yesterday, I thought I should do a 30 minutes or 40 minutes, I'm gonna do a Kingdom Hearts stream. It won't be directly ASMR, but it certainly won't be super hypey, as you say, Gort. I was gonna do an afternoon RuneScape stream, and I think I still will be able to and shave and do all my Sunday stuff, but my parents are at Michael's. Oh, you're gonna use all your points. My parents are at Michael's cheer competition, and they asked me to let their dog out in early afternoon, so that might get in the way, and they live like 30, 40 minutes away. Second stream, so it might be at night for the RuneScape one. And the last announcement, and I'm gonna make a couple 1 minute ASMRs out at my parents, which will go directly on YouTube. And the last announcement is this Thursday, we're going to drag bingo. Barco, I'm about to get off. But I'm gonna do, Kingdom Hearts here in like 30 minutes, so hopefully you can stick around, Barco. And it won't be explicitly ASMR, but it'll be chill. Drag bingo this Thursday with my friends who love to do stuff, like they always want to go out, so I was hoping to do something that I enjoy too. I've never been to the drag bingo, so I'll miss Thursday's stream. So this Sunday obviously I'm doing an extra ASMR, and then next Sunday too, and possibly even the Sunday after that. I'm gonna look so young after I do this, and then later I'm shaving. No drag for me. I already get like called out enough while I'm there for being like the obvious poorly dressed cis guy or whatever. So yeah, if you're new to the channel and tuning in, I do this normally on Thursdays. For my folks who live in different time zones, I was doing a little extra stream of all my presents I got. Let's see my actual pile of what I'll keep. No, not even a, I don't have a blonde Karen. Does the audience usually dress up for drag stuff? I don't really go to much. They're always so late at night. This one's at like 7, so I can make it. So I got tissues and hand sanitizer. Anal beads, some fluffy socks, and some more socks. Yeah, thanks for reminding me, Barco. That's actually a good call. I remembered it for drag brunch because it was an actual, like, it was an actual, drag show. Like, they're singing and stuff. This one, I don't think they sing and all that, but you're right, I should still bring singles. I'm sure they obviously still will dress up and take a lot of time for that. Well, I almost finished my coffee, and I'm a very structured guy, and at 10, I drink my protein shake. After I get a few things done, I'll set watch, going to watch my parents' dog for a bit. They have the arcade machines, and they got a Mortal Kombat one. They got, like, a actual arcade machine with Mortal Kombat 1, 2, and 3. So I'm stoked for that. I'm going to play that for a bit. And I got to fit in my nap. Have to tuck. And yeah, singles, yeah, we give, you know, basically tips for them. Dressing up. Do you guys not tip drag, what do you call them? Drag queens in Britain? I know tipping isn't normalized in general in Europe, but I didn't know if maybe drag shows are a little different because it's rooted in, well, actually, I have no idea. Maybe England has its own drag history. Stuff. Like I said, I'm usually the butt of all the jokes when I'm at one. Oh, you guys just too fancy. I really like this container, but I don't really eat candy, so if anybody's nearby, I got you on a lot of candy. That sounds painful. For now, but in like 30 minutes, I'll be back for some Kingdom Hearts. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream, and thanks for sticking around, Courts. I know it's better for your time zone. I won't always be able to do it so early, but I'm glad I was able to. So yeah, look out for another notification in about 30 minutes for Kingdom Hearts. Cheers, all.